I'm Michael Harris, online editor of HydroRoll.com for Penwell, and here are this week's Hydro headlines. We had a great time meeting many of you in Nashville, Tennessee during Hydrovision International 2014, and as always, there were a number of important announcements made at the conference and exhibition. Leading the way is General Electric, whose measurement and control business launched its new Bentley Nevada Advanced Distributed Architecture Platform Technology Hydro Monitor. The 3701/46, or ADAPT, units were specifically designed for the protection and condition monitoring of hydro turbines and provide users with data to help predict machine failure, prevent unforeseen downtime, and to improve overall reliability and availability of hydro machinery. The units are optimized for the lower speeds of hydro turbines, GE says, and incorporate specialized measurements to detect rough load zone, propeller, blade or bucket NX frequencies, cavitation, and conventional measurements of shaft radial position and vibration, thrust position, and absolute vibration using proximity probes, accelerometers, and velocity sensors. The ADAPT unit's compact size allows mounting near the hydro units and also use GE's System 1 Evolution Basic software, adding additional troubleshooting and diagnostic capabilities. Voith Hydro also used Hydrovision to unveil its new Stream Driver Turbine, which are modular, run-of-river units designed for installation on streams, canals, and other low-head infrastructure previously unutilized for hydro development. Each unit can produce up to 800 kilowatts of power, Voith says, with developers looking to take advantage of recent federal legislation as a primary target. With Congress passing the Hydropower Regulatory Efficiency and Reclamation Small Conduit Hydropower and Rural Jobs Acts last year, the process to develop generating capacity at unpowered federal infrastructure has been streamlined for qualifying hydro projects. It was also announced last week that the replacement for British Columbia's John Hart plant has begun. The $94 million project is the most expensive ever undertaken by owner BC Hydro and will take 5 years to complete. The upgrade and rehabilitation work includes a new replacement intake at the John Hart Spillway Dam, replacement tunnels, construction of a new power plant, and a new water bypass. The project will raise the 65-year-old plant's generating capacity from 128 megawatts to 138 megawatts, BC Hydro says, while also addressing safety, reliability, and environmental concerns. And last, Hydro Group publisher Marla Barnes had a chance to catch up with Hydro Consulting and Maintenance Services on the floor at Hydrovision to learn more about what HCMS is working on. So reporting from Nashville, here's Marla Barnes.
Here at the Hydrovision International 2014 event, we had over 336 exhibitors. One of those is Hydro Consulting and Maintenance Services, and I caught up with my buddy Ken Hostler here. Ken, good to see you today.
Good to see you. Thanks.
Yeah. How are things going with your company?
Very good. We've had another good year this year, and since we've last seen you, it's been very exciting, a lot of good projects, and it's been quite busy, actually.
Yeah, well, we're here with some of your colleagues. That's great.
Yes, yes. I'd like to, one of the special projects that we've had this year, significant for us and significant for the industry, is managed by our Chris Parrish, manager of project engineering, and Chris is here. I think he can tell you a little bit about Murray Dam.
Yeah, Chris, I hear you're working on one of the most world-renowned projects.
Yes, it's Murray Hydro is the world's largest pit turbine, 8.4 meter. We've had the pleasure of actually replacing the mechanical seal, the original installed mechanical seal with a conventional packing box, completely engineered, designed in-house, and manufactured. And we're now doing a complete overhaul on Unit 2. It's the city of North Little Rock. They're great customer to work with and a great opportunity for HCMS.
Well, congratulations and thanks for sharing that with us.
Thank you.
You know, here we're at Hydrovision International. We've been celebrating 20 years strong of Hydrovision, but there's another anniversary going on right here at Hydro Consulting and Maintenance Services. Ken, your boss, Mr. Clyde Kraut, is celebrating 50 years in the hydro industry. Clyde, that's quite an accomplishment.
Thank you. I started 1964 with Alice Chalmers, where I got my training and education. I then went with Voith Hydro and left Voith and went with Siemens. And after Siemens, I met Lorraine and she convinced me to start our own company, Hydro Consulting Maintenance Service, and we've been going strong ever since.
That's great.
This marks the 50th year.
Well, congratulations. And congratulations to Lorraine as well for being one of the Women with Hydro Vision winners this year. Well, that wraps up this edition of Hydro World Weekly Hydro Headlines, brought to you by Hydro Consulting and Maintenance Services.